Meanwhile, on Central, the cameras are on the lookout for any sign of trolley rage in Supermarket Sweep.
Are you ready to go shopping? Step inside a very special supermarket, the only supermarket in the world that gives you money. £2,000 is waiting on our shelves to be won by some lucky person in this store. The aim of the game is to shop smarter and faster than the next person. And everything in this supermarket is up for grabs. Go on, fill your trolley as high as you can, because shopping has never been so much fun. Yes, there's prizes in store and much, much more when you play Supermarket Sweep. So let's welcome today's shoppers, who are Kelly Rogers and Laura Matthews from Lincolnshire. Jason Allen and Ian Sweet from Gloucester and Bristol. And Lynn Crisp and Vanessa Noble from Kent. You're all on Supermarket Sweep. And here's your host, Dale Winton.
Thank you. Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to Supermarket Sweep. Good morning, beautiful shoppers.
Morning,
Dale. Oh, they're happy, they're smiling, because they know that in less than half an hour, they could be leaving the checkout with £2,000. Oh, yes. And I'll tell you how you do that. You're going to tear around the supermarket, hopefully go for the super sweep. But before that, you need to get some time on those clocks. You do that by answering questions on shopping and general knowledge. The more time they have, the more shopping they can do. You can have a minute to start with. And you can have 10 seconds and maybe £25 on your subtotal if you get this one right. But what product am I looking for? The mini sweep. Toast and marmalade or cereals usually, or for breakfast have the famous Swiss... Ian?
Pancake, Dale?
Is not the right answer. Vanessa?
Muesli, Dale.
Muesli is the right answer. Muesli, muesli. Okay. Vanessa, I've just given you the 10 seconds. That means, Lynn, you've got to run the mini sweep. The muesli's out there somewhere in the supermarket. It's got one of these on, the sweep logo. Kay. You bring it back to me within 30 seconds, it'll add a further 25 quid to your subtotal.
Right.
Right, she says. Are you ready for action?
Think so, Dale.
Off you go.
One.
Run around my supermarket.
I did. I know where everything else is.
You know everything else is. Am I mistaken, or are you wearing leather head to toe?
Oh, I am, Dale.
Well, it's fabulous, isn't it?
Mm.
It is really fabulous. Well, I think we'll do the rest of the show together like this. Go and join Vanessa, and I'll have a chat in just a moment. I'm sorry. Leather does something to me, it really does. Laura and Kelly, good morning.
Good morning, Dale.
Friends and housemates studying at, Nottingham Trent University.
Mm-hmm. That's
right, the area well. What are you studying, Laura?
Business administration.
And Kelly?
Business administration.
To do what eventually? Going to government, I should think.
I've just got a job in a management consultant, Dale.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
And what about you, Laura?
Well, I'm still looking.
You're still looking?
Yeah, so if anybody wants to offer.
Well, you never know, you see. I mean, they'll be watching today. I wish you luck. Kelly and Laura, welcome to the sweep. Well, a dodgy start for you two boys this morning,
Dale.
I must say. Pancakes, indeed.
I know.
Jason and Ian from Bristol and Gloucester, you're good friends. And you look young enough to be students, but not you work, don't you? What do you do,
Dale.
Ian?
I'm actually a volunteer manager for a transport organisation
right.
in Bristol.
It says you double-check everything, and you lock the door, turn off the lights, and do all this twice. Is that right, Jason?
Well, I do all that, Dale, and then I've still forgotten something, so I still have to go back, yeah.
Well, isn't that nothing wrong with being a bit security-minded? And your nickname's Jay Bird.
That's right, Dale, yeah.
Why Jay Bird?
Well, my friends started calling me Jay, and then it developed into Jay Bird for some reason. I can't remember why, but...
Oh, you're not telling me. He does, but he's not telling me. But I wish you luck.
Keep quiet.
Well, I'll get to the bottom of it sooner or later.
I'm sure you will.
Oh, what are you like this morning? Oh, we've got a naughty crowd.
It's all the leather by me, darling.
It's the leather. I know. I'm leaning on this for support at the thought of all this leather, I tell you. Ian and Jason, good luck on the suite.
Thank you.
Vanessa and Lynn, good morning.
Good morning.
Oh, that leather. Oh, that leather. Now, listen, Lynn.
Yes.
Now, on a serious note, why were you trying to take a stuffed pig on a bus?
Oh, yeah.
It was and they tried to charge you for it.
They charged me a seat for her Christmas present. It was like, you know, getting on the bus, nightmare, Christmas. Had to push it on the bus, literally. He went, I don't think so. I said, look, how else am I going to get this home?
And we've met before, Vanessa, haven't
yeah,
we?
Yeah.
You were one of the decoys in the programme The Other Half, weren't
yeah.
you? Which was great. Did you enjoy that?
Yeah, I did. It's a brilliant day.
Yeah, well, you might make some money today. Lynn and Vanessa, good luck on the suite.
Thank you.
So, I think we'll do some serious shopping. Laura, Ian and Vanessa, I'll see you later on for game. But Lynn, Jason and Kelly, step forward. We are going to get some time on those clocks. Well, you're all very welcome, and I wish you luck as we go into Dale's Bluff. Would this face lie? It just might. Dale's Bluff, am I telling the truth, or is it a fib? You get to press true or false. Here's your first one. Saddle is a cut of lamb. What do you reckon? Please vote true or false. Saddle is a cut of lamb. You've all voted. Kelly, what do you think?
False, Dale.
And Jason?
True, Dale.
And Lynn?
False, Dale.
Actually, Jason's right. It is true. You get 10 seconds. Well done, Jason. Oysterback is a cut of bacon. Please vote. Make your choice. True or false? Oysterback is a cut of bacon. You've all voted. What do you reckon, Kelly?
False, Dale.
And Jason?
False, Dale.
And Lynn?
True.
It is true. Would I lie to you? Well done, Lynn. You get 10 seconds. Good. What do you reckon to this one? Servelat is a German pudding. Servelat is a German pudding. Please vote. Make your choice. True or false? And you've all voted Kelly.
True, Dale.
Jason.
False, Dale.
And Lynn.
False, Dale.
Actually, it is true. That's exactly what it is. Kelly, well done. You've added 10 seconds. Okay. We're now going to play word search. I wish you luck on this. This is where the words are hidden among lots of other words. Once I've given you a clue, I want the answer, but not only the word I'm looking for, but where it appears on the puzzle. Either down, across, or diagonal. Okay. I need both bits of information, the word and where it sits on the puzzle. Here we go. There's your board, here's your clue. Your clue is important in any bakery, ground in a big mill, and it begins with the letter F. Kelly.
Flour across, Dale.
Here's the right answer, there it is. Flour, 10 seconds. This one's a wafer-thin pastry filled with a sweet filling, usually apples. And Jason. Kelly.
Strudel across, Dale.
Here's the right answer, yeah, well done. There it is. Okay. This one's a gooseberry puree cum dessert. Absolutely delicious. And another clue would be comics play the blank. Lynn.
Fall down.
Fall down is right. From the down line, there it is. And here's your last one. This one's a type of flour used to make pasta. And Kelly.
Bran across, Dale.
No, it's not the right answer. I was about to say it begins with a D. It's a well-known type of flour. The word I'm looking for is Durham, and it's on the diagonal line. There it is. Never mind. I'd say it was a good time to bring back your partners. Well, shoppers, all clocks have been added to, albeit Ian and Jason with just 10 seconds. You have a minute and 10. Vanessa and Lynn, you have a minute and 30. And Laura and Kelly, you also have 1 minute and 30. Kelly, Jason and Lynn, we shall get reacquainted later for the round robin, but returning players, come forward. I've got a game for you. Okay, here's one of my famous pricing games. We're going to call this one Pick a Pair. The deal here is if one of you gives me the correct answer, I'll give you 10 seconds as usual. However, if you all agree on the same correct answer, there's a bonus 20, making a full half a minute. As we pay Pick a Pair, now I will tell you that I will sell you the savoury rice for 55 pence. Good at any price, I reckon. 55 pence. Ah, you've got three other products. Which one of those matches it in price to make a pair? Would it be the jar of mayonnaise? Number one, would it be the tin of spaghetti? Number two, or would it be number three, the sponge scourers? What do you reckon? Which one of those three items will make a pair with the savoury rice in terms of price, i.e. 55 pence? Please vote, make your choice. One, two, or three. You've all voted. Laura, what do you reckon?
Number two.
Number two, which is the spaghetti. Ian?
Number one, Dale.
Number one, the mayo. And Vanessa?
Number three, Dale.
Number oh, all gone for something different. The scourers, let me tell you. Now, you know the savoury rice is 55 pence. Number one, the mayonnaise actually does sell for 55 pence. That's the one I was looking for. Ian, well done. You've got 10 seconds. The spaghetti's 28 pence. And the scourers are 77 pence. So, Ian, well done. You now have a lot more in your pie. Yes! We're going to play random reveal. I'm going to give you the answer, but a bit at a time. I'll let you reveal one letter at a time at random to help you get the product or item I'm looking for. There'll be an initial clue, okay? Here's your clue for this one. Sliced, diced, and good in borscht. Let's have a letter. T. Ian.
Sorry, Dale.
Gone? Let's have another letter. B. T. E. Laura?
Beetroot.
Is the right answer, yes. And Ian knew afterwards, Ian knew. Let's have another one. This one's a treat on meat. Treat on meat. Let's have a letter. U. O. I. N. Vanessa?
Onion sauce, Dale.
It's not the right answer, but a good guess. Let's have another one. D. S. Laura?
Dijon mustard.
We'll do nicely. 10 seconds. Good. I reckon you'd all get this one straight away when I say to you, this one's Spanish tipple. A Spanish tipple. Let's have a letter. A. Yes, Ian?
Sangria, Dale.
Absolutely right. 10 seconds. Well done. And all I'm going to say to you on this one is, in a jam. In a jam. Let's have a letter. B. And an E. R. I. Ian.
Strawberries, Dale.
We'll do nicely. Strawberry jam. That's right. 10 seconds. Okay. How well have you done so far? All will be revealed just seconds away from the round robin, so let's bring back your partners. Well, shoppers, the good news is there's only 10 seconds separating you. Lynn and Vanessa, you have a minute and 30. Jason and Ian, you have a minute and 40. And Kelly and Laura, you have 1 minute and 50. What you add to your clocks now is what you'll take with you out there into the supermarket. Your last chance to do so in the round robin, which means that returning players come forward. You're going to go first. Quick answer, and then you all change. And it's all about the world of TV. Stephanie Beecham starred in a wartime drama with a fruity name. What was it? And I could do a song. Yes, we have... Now I'm showing my age here. No bananas. Change. Let's have another one. Which ex-Minders star stood for election in An Independent Man? Ian.
Dennis Waterman, Dale.
No, you got the wrong one.
Was it George Cole?
It was George Cole. Well done, 10 seconds. Good change. Could you tell me the name of Anthea Turner's ex-Radio 1 DJ husband, Anne Kelly?
Peter Powell, Dale.
She is married to Peter, that's right, 10 seconds. Change. Which ER heartthrob is the current... Laura?
George Clooney.
Batman George Clooney, right, 10 seconds. Change. In which television series would you find Agent Scully and Agent Mulder? Lynn.
Oh, my God. The X-Files.
Is the right answer. 10 seconds, change. In which comedy show would you find the characters Charlie and Caroline? Laura.
Is it The Upper Hand?
It is The Upper Hand. Well done. 10 seconds. Good. That takes care of the round robin. Here's what you've got to go shopping with. Lynn and Vanessa, you have 1 minute and 40. Jason and Ian, you also have 1 minute and 40. And Kelly and Laura, you have 2 minutes and 30. So, which member of each team is going to be tearing around the aisles? It will be Laura, Ian and Vanessa. Oh, good luck. They'll be back in just a few moments as I will, hopefully going through to the Super Sweep and the 2 grand. Where else? Supermarket Sweep.
How many more of these are there?
A couple more, I think. Are you coming out tonight?
What do you think?
Depends if she let you out. Right. I bet we catch all the traffic tonight.
When you spend 8 hours a day tending your flock, you haven't time to enjoy Paxo on a Sunday, so I cook new Paxo Partners during the week.
The French use them to look for the wounded.
They said if a Briard could help a man, he would never pass him by.
Their courts look after them. And this does the job from the inside.
They can't get enough of the stuff. Napoleon said an army marches on its stomach, and he had a couple of Briards.
Ours certainly wear the kids out.
Pedigree Chum Complete. Top breeders, the Rouals and the family recommend it.
Now I have started using this new Persil Performance. That shirt, Max's favourite. Wherever he is, whatever he's doing, he'll be wearing it. So when I get to wash it, I have to get it looking good. This new Persil Performance helps stop the colours running into the whites. It acts like a barrier, so the shirt stays clean and bright. Unlike the old one, he couldn't put that shirt through anything more, so I wouldn't wash it in anything less.
New Persil Performance.
Many people have trouble with reading, writing or maths. But improving your basic skills can help in all sorts of ways.
It's much better. I can now read to my son.
So give the National Basic Skills Agency a call.
Promotion meant paperwork, and there's no way I could have coped with that before.
That'll be £4.62, please.
Just being able to check I've got the right change.
They'll put you in touch with a local course and explain how easy it is to improve your basic skills. Call free on 0800 700 987.
I'm getting traces of blossom and buttercups. A faint twang of heather on a warm breeze, and it's all mingled with newly sprung bluebells.
With new gentle breeze bounce in your dryer.
And the haunting scent of clover-strewn hillside.
You get the freshness of drying outside, inside. Gentle breeze, the delicate new fragrance from Bounce.
And there's a whiff of hollyhocks waiting to whoosh up your nose.
It's a rollover this Wednesday with an estimated jackpot of £14 million. It could be you.
Welcome back to Supermarket Sweep. Now, earlier we saw our teams do so well building up time on their clocks. That's the time they have to go shopping. Who's going to go first? Well, Kelly and Laura, you did a cracking time of 2 minutes and 30, so you're going to go first. Followed by Jason and Ian with 1 minute and 40. And exactly the same time with 1 minute and 40 is Lynn and Vanessa. So you're in strict competition with each other, but it isn't what you've got, it's how well you use what you've got. Okay? Have a look around the supermarket. You can have what you like, actually. Especially take the old sell-by date numbers, if you don't mind. Get rid of some of them today. Now, load your trolley high and wide. I won't charge you for a single item. Worth remembering, the inflatable bonuses, they're dotted all over the supermarket. One to a shopper, but grab one because they can be worth up to 100 quid. We've also got Pick a Mix over there with the lovely Rhiannon. She will help you weigh out 5 varieties of sweets to the weight of 500 grams. You do that, I'll give you 50 quid. And there's another 50 quid on offer with the old pricing guns over there. Those items need doing today. A dozen items at today's right price. Back to the checkout, another 50 quid. And you can have £100 with this. This is my shopping list. If you bring me back one of each of these, I promise you I'll put 100 quid on your subtotal. I need today a tub of margarine, a tin of Irish stew, and some spray deodorant. One of each of those, 100 quid on your subtotal. One question. Are you ready to go shopping?
Yes, sir.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. Kelly and Laura, I'm going to count you in. 3, 2, 1, go!
And it is Laura who lunges into the lucrative lanes this morning and the Pick and Mix and hopefully the £50 bonus as she weighs up the sweets down there. Plenty of support coming in from Kelly and a good start hopefully for the pink team. Yes, they're weighed up. Well done, Laura. Whoa. Goes up the trolley and down towards the fruit and veg and picks up that bounty bonus. Pricing, shouts Kelly to Laura. And no sooner said than done as she picks up the gun. And Ian and Vanessa get away together. Ian goes down towards the Pick and Mix. And the tins are nicely priced up for Laura. Irish stew, shouts Lynn to Vanessa. Yes, I'm a bit peckish myself. Now, they're down there. No, not the right one, Vanessa. Ian goes in for the sweets. He's still weighing those up. Look, he's taking his time. Come on, Ian, get a wiggle on. It's a baking tray this time for Laura. And it's the spray on deodorant for Vanessa. That's on the old shopping list. It's a drinks break for Laura. And we're still at the sweets with Ian. Now the margarine, that's on Dale's shopping list. And finally, Ian picks up the pricing gun and starts to price up those tins. And Laura races round without her trolley looking for the margarine on Dale's shopping list and takes no chances, picks up one of each. That's always a good manoeuvre. Yes, she's jogging along now. Now it's videos this time for Vanessa. She hasn't got a trolley either. Laura picks her trolley up and Ian picks up the tins. Nicely priced and in the bag. Now, where are we going? Laura doesn't know if she's coming or going. There's a bounty bonus there for Vanessa. And Kelly's still shouting out those shopping instructions there. As Ian picked up a video, he could have had three of those. He only picked one of them up. Back at the pick and mix with Vanessa sorting the sweets out as Ian looks for the margarine on Dale's shopping list. He gets that. Well, he's got two there. That's all right. Cleaning fluids going in for Laura this time. And the sweets still going in the bag for Vanessa. A good turn round the corner from Ian. And we're going backwards with Laura this time. This could end in tears, everybody. He's got the hairspray on Dale's shopping list. And finally, Vanessa. No, she hasn't. The sweets are all over the floor. Now, come on. Get yourselves together now. It's Nappy's going in there. And it's back to Dale.
Come on back, Stoppard. Come on back. Yes. What a sweet Bobby Bragg for guiding us through that. That was fantastic. Come on, Laura. Come on, Ian. We're going to let the girls run all these items through the till to find out who's going to go for the super sweep. So, let's check them out.
While they put that lot through the tills, we've got time for a home viewer game. And it's as simple as this. All you have to do is name the item that we're looking for, already featured on today's show. This is the name of the item with some of the letters missing. Here's a little clue to what we're looking for. A Swiss breakfast mixture with milk. If you think that you know the answer, then give us a call on this number, 0891 333 555. Here's that clue again. A Swiss breakfast mixture with milk. It's as easy as that. So go on and give us a call. Dale.
Thank you, Rihanna. I'm confused. I thought it was pumpernickel, but that wouldn't fit, would it? Never mind. Listen, dial Dale and be a winner. One lucky caller picked at random will win £250 on the day. Oh, and don't forget the five runner-up prizes of the sweep board game and the sweep quiz book as well. So dial Dale, be lucky. Oh, and well worth remembering, at the end of the series, just before Christmas, whether you've locked a correct answer or not on the day, you still might be driving away in that brand new car. So be lucky. Let's do those shopping totals. Lynn and Vanessa. You may well grin at me like that. You went tearing off without your trolley, didn't you?
Yeah, well,
and you were dropping your frozen veg, and you were. And Lynn was going mad. Going mad. But I think it looks quite good. To start with, what have you got there, Lynn? Is that a full shopping list?
It is, Dale, yes.
£100, that's good. Yes, £100. And you've got an inflatable. What's your inflatable worth? Let's have a look.
£25,
good. Now, you've seen this, you made a mistake with the pick and mix because it's not the right weight, is it? So I can't give you anything for that. But I will tell you that when you add those together, your subtotal is 125. That's all right. I'll put it together with the value of the goods in your trolley, gives you a grand total on sweep today of £162. Good shopping. The boys in blue, Jason and Ian, let's have a look. We were overflowing. First of all, Jason, peel off the sticker on that inflatable bonus. What's it worth? Let's have a look. It is...
£50.
£50, that's good, that'll do for me. And what have you got there? You've got the pick and mix.
I've got the pick and mix, Dale.
And that's £50 for that.
My pricing gun was firing blanks halfway through, but I managed to do it eventually.
Oh, so did you? Thank you for telling me that. That's another £50, good. And is that a full shopping list?
No, Dale, I didn't get the Irish stew.
Oh, you didn't, did you? Oh, no, never mind. Gives you a subtotal of 150. Which boys, I will add to the value of the goods in your sort of like spacious trolley, I'd call it this morning, gives you a grand total today of £186. It's a good shot. Kelly and Laura, let's have a look. What have we got here? Well, looks good. You've got the pick and mix, that's £50.
Yep.
And a bonus, the guitar bonus. That went straight away, Kelly. I saw you grab that straight away. Let's have a look at...
£75.
£75, good. Laura... Would that be a full and filled shopping list?
It is.
That's £100. And you've got the pricing gun items as well. That's another £50. I'll have to tell you what your subtotal is. It's fabulous. Your subtotal today on Supermarket Sweep is £275. You know you're running the sweep because it beats the other two prices. However, when I put that together with the value of the goods in your trolley, just so you know, great shop today. Your grand total is £387. We're going to do the suite. Jason and Ian, Lynn and Vanessa, thanks for being wonderful shoppers. Have a good day. Well, you did very well, didn't you?
Yes.
You did very well indeed. Now, somewhere out there in the supermarket, there is £2,000 hidden in cash. I would love you to go home with the money today. I'm sure you've got a good way of spending it, haven't you?
It's already spent.
What have you spent it on? What would you do?
Wardrobe, you name it, I've spent it.
Oh, holiday. Fantastic. Well, in that case, you have to go home with the money, don't you?
Yeah.
You have to. Now, here's how you get the cash. You solve the clues that will lead you to three specially marked products. Your money's behind the third item. Your minute won't begin until I've read you this, which happens to be the first clue. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
You ready? Here I'm we ready. Go. Good, okay. Take it steady. Won't start until I finish this. Many fish finger meals pass a child's lips with dollops of blank blank to accompany the chips.
Smarter ketchup.
It is! Go!
If yodeling you hate, do as I'm told. Just push him down a hill and make the
Swiss roll.
Swiss roll. Swiss roll. Swiss roll. Swiss roll.
Is all that it takes. Forget eggs and bacon and go for
cornflakes.
Ran.
Shoppers, come on back. Oh dear, oh dear. Oh, you saw it.
A minute too late.
A minute, about a second, I know. Oh, that is terrible. It was bran flakes, and you were going, cornflakes. Oh dear, oh dear, I am sorry.
Never mind.
Oh, never mind. Well, I'm glad. I mean, what are you going to do? I'll lend you
five. I've
cancelled my holiday. Oh, don't say that. Don't say that. Have you had a good day?
Yes,
oh, definitely.
Well, you're going home with the value of the goods in your trolley, which is something, I guess.
Brilliant.
That takes care of another day on Supermarket Sweep. And remember, the next time you're at the checkout and you hear the beep, think of the fun you could be having on
Supermarket Sweep.
Have a good day.